Let's talk about levels of measurement. There are four levels of measurement: nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Nominal and ordinal are qualitative data. Interval and ratio are quantitative data. Nominal numbers are used only to classify the data. An example is ID number. If your ID number is 1, 2, 3, 4 and the other one is 5, 6, 7, 8, it doesn't mean you perform lesser or perform better or lesser than the other. You have gender, so you have 1 for male and 2 for female. So it is just for naming and label. Ordinal attributes can be rank order. Example, educational attainment. So in an educational attainment, you have high school, college, master's, then you will have doctor's degree. Pageant winner. So pageant winner, you have first runner-up, second, third, fourth runner-up. Interval, difference between data is meaningful. So, and no absolute zero. An example is IQ. So the IQ, let me search. You have superior, 120 to 129, high average, 110 to 119, average, 90 to 109, and low average, 80 to 89. So there is no zero in IQ. Everyone has his or her own unique intelligence. You still remember the multiple intelligences? So what is your IQ? And we have temperature. Temperature is also under interval. There is meaning in between the data. So when you say 7 degrees Celsius and 10 degrees Celsius, so the in-between data are also meaningful. And there is no absolute zero, because when you say 0 degrees Celsius, that is equivalent to 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So that is really not an absolute zero. That is temperature. And for our last, that is ratio, there is an absolute zero. An example is length. So it is 5 centimeter, 3 meters. So you also have 0 meter or 0 centimeter. So the idea of zero in ratio is absolute, or it exists. And the same with weight, 0, 0 kilogram, and so on. So there is an absolute zero in length and in weight. Again, when we say ratio, absolute zero. Interval, no absolute zero, but the data in between is meaningful. Ordinal is ranking, but the data in between has no meaning, while nominal, you have that data just for naming and labeling. Okay, so that's all for the levels of measurement. If you are still confused, you may ask me. You may comment below for your questions, and I will answer it. Thank you for listening for our levels of measurement. See you next time for our next lesson. Have a good day. Goodbye, class.